Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 8.1, Problem 5. This is Section 8.1, Problem Number 5. It says, according to the Massachusetts Registry of Motor Vehicles, there are 4,799,180 registered vehicles in the state of Massachusetts that travel an average distance of 15,291 miles per year, with a standard deviation of 3,479 miles. What is the probability that a random sample of 49 vehicles registered in Massachusetts has an average annual mileage of more than 15,000, less than 15,000, more than 12,000, and less than 12,000? So what we have to do is find the z-score for 15,000 as an average of a sample of 49 vehicles, not any one vehicle, but an average of 49. So we go to the z-score formula. Z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. So z equals x, the number I need a z-score for is 15,000, minus the mean for how many miles driven in a year is 15,291. Now again, for this problem, I want the mean of many samples of 49 vehicles, which would be the same as the mean of the population. Now the standard deviation would be different between the population and a sample of 49 vehicles. The population has a standard deviation of 3,479, but many groups of 49 would have a standard deviation of the population standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. That would be the standard deviation or measure of spread in data from one group of 49 vehicles to the next in terms of the average of how many miles driven per year. So let's simplify this down a little bit. Z equals, on top I can do the subtraction, 15,000 minus 15,291 is negative 291. Pay attention to the signs. Now in the denominator, you would have 3479 divided by square root of 49 is 7, because 7 times 7 is 49. That's a nice whole number square root. And that would give me z equals negative 291 over, surprisingly, 7 divides into 3479 evenly. It goes in 497 times. Just double check that with my calculator. Yep, sure enough, 497. So now the next step I can't really do without my calculator. I have to divide negative 291 divided by 497. So the calculator does stuff like that with no problem at all. So let's see what I get for an answer. Negative 291 divided by 497 gives me a result of negative 0.58551308. Don't lose the negative. So this is the z-score that we need to look up in that z-score chart. So to look up anything in the standard normal chart, first you have to write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. I have 0.58 something. The 8 is the second place out. The next one after the 8 is big enough to make it a negative 0.59. So now that I have the number written so that it has two places after the decimal, the next step is to split it into two separate parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So I have negative 0.5, pull a 9 off to one side. After that, I put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that I pulled off. So instead of 9, it's 0.09. Now I can go into that chart, look in the negative 0.9, negative 0.5 row, the 0.9 column, and I would intersect those. They intersect at 0.2776. That's the number from the chart. Now again, that may or may not be the final answer. It does happen to be the final answer to B. So if you look, it's the same number, 15,000, but B says less than. So for a less than question, the number from the chart is the final answer. It's almost a 28% probability, or 27.75% probability, that a group of 49 cars would have an average that's less than 15,000. So for more than, you have to do 1 minus the chart value, which would be 0.7224. So about a 72.25% probability that a group of 49 cars would have an average that's greater than 15,000. So that's A and B. That we can kind of do those together because they have the same 15,000. One is more than, one is less than. And the C and D are very much the same too. So we have to do the same process except for 12,000 miles. So we have to find a z-score for 12,000 miles. And again, that's a z-score not for any one car, but for a group of 49 cars having an average of 12,000. So let me make a little room under my z-score formula and just fill it in for 12,000. So z equals x, the number to find the z-score for, is 12,000. Minus the mean, or average value. Again, it will be the same as the mean of the population, 15,291. Standard deviation, now again, standard deviation of the samples of size 49. It would be the same number as last time, the standard deviation of the population, which was 3,479 over the square root of the sample size, or square root of 49, because there are 49 cars in each sample. And we'll simplify that. So in the numerator, you'll have 12,000 minus 15,291 is negative 3,291. That I can do. Now the denominator is going to be the same as before. You'd have 3,479 divided by 7. Again, square root of 49 is 7. And remember, last time it went in evenly for 497. So since it did last time, I'm certain that it will go in evenly again. You'll have negative 3,291 over 497. So again, that's not a division that I can do without my calculator. Calculator will do it easily, though. So I'll take my calculator. I'll do negative 3,291 divided by 497. So negative 3,291 gets entered first, divided by 497 equals, and the calculator says negative 6.621730382. So we can go through the process of looking this up, but I can see right now we're off the chart. I mean, you can write it so that it has two places after the decimal. And you'd be in the negative 6.6 row. There is no negative 6.6 row. You're way off the chart on this. The last row on the chart is going to be negative 3.5. So what that means is it's pretty much impossible to find randomly a sample of 49 cars where the average of that sample of 49 would come out less than 12,000. So the probability that it's more than 12,000 is about 100%. It's a guarantee. So again, that's not any one driver. That's a group of 49 cars having an average that's less than 12,000. For one driver, just out of curiosity, probability that they drive less than 12,000 is about a 17% probability. More than 12,000 in a year is 83%. That's just for one driver. But for a group of 49, for the average to come out less than 12,000, within any type of sensible round off, it's impossible. So you'd have many, many zeros before you'd hit a non-zero digit.